Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to our Planet Zoo Amsterdam inspired zoo build. And the first little bit of this video isn't really going to make sense. So as you can tell from the thumbnail, today we're building a sloth habitat. That was not the original plan. Leaf Productions, and I'll link it down below, came out with a beautiful mod that makes or adds a three-throated? That's terrifying. A brown-throated three-toed sloth into the game. And whilst I wasn't really intending on touching mods at all in this playthrough, the idea is very much to... Look at those penises. The idea is very much to focus on the ibex and the lynx, and that's what I'm building here. It's a sloth. So, you know, I could not possibly resist. It's the first proper sloth mod we've had, and obviously I had to work with it. So, I did the first hour and a half or so of what you're seeing here. This was going to be our lynxy, ibexy sort of area. And then I ignored it all and went and made a sloth habitat somewhere else, basically. So this is all not super relevant to what's going on later, but it will be relevant, assumedly, in the next video and onwards from there. So the idea was very much getting out of the city a little bit into a more alpine sort of area. I really wanted to feel like you're sort of in a whole new world, to an extent, and there's big tall mountains and loads of trees, and it's all snowy, and it's kind of like this Scandinavian sort of vibe to it. We're very much not in the Netherlands anymore. There's no mountains this tall in the Netherlands. And I also really like the idea, because obviously we're doing our train track, I like the idea of the train going through the mountains. And that train is actually going to link back through into the zoo, which is where the sloth habitat is. So it does all come together eventually. It was quite fun making that. I've never really made, oddly enough, a mountain in Planet Zoo before. I've never had to full-on make a mountain, you know, like this style of mountain. It's actually quite a challenge. The ones in the distance behind me look really good. You know, they look great, but the problem is they have a custom texture. They are clearly not done using the Planet Zoo texture tools, because the Planet Zoo texture tools look a lot more... The pattern is very noticeable, the repeating pattern is very noticeable. And that's a bit of a shame. But covering it in trees kind of does the trick, and this is what a lot of mountains look like, especially in alpine or sort of Scandi kind of areas, so... This was a little fun little detour for me, doing something I've never really ever done before. And I think it's going to look really cool eventually later on. And it's nice to get out of the city. You know, I've done so much work in the city now, I've done so much building work. Although we're going to do a lot more in this video. it's been cool to work on something a little bit different. Just basically what I'm doing is I'm using the brush, the auto paint brush. And that puts grass down on any relatively flat surface. So I went over with the auto brush, and then if there was grass, I put trees there, essentially, and that's just kind of how I denoted it. But not going to do too much more on this building, a little forest. You're going to basically just drop off the side of the city and into the wilderness. We will make that into more of a official exit, and it'll get fancier later on. You know, I was kind of just working on this when I saw the sloth, so things had to change pretty quickly. Apologies if I stop talking every now and again. I've shredded my tongue. My tooth chipped and it's really sharp. And now it just keeps... I keep cutting myself on my own tongue, basically. Not a sentence many people have probably said. Oh, wait, no, I don't cut myself on my tongue. That's nonsense. I keep cutting my own tongue on my tooth. Really painful. Anyways, yeah, trees. So I just picked a bunch of trees I liked. And not done quite yet. No, not yet, not yet. Flattening down some land. I wasn't totally sure what the canal was going to do behind. I knew I wanted the canal behind the museum. You're not meant to... The museum, the train station. You're not really meant to go behind the train station because I didn't really do much detail work there. I might have to now, thanks to what we're doing here. But I think that's basically going to end. I'd like to move away from the canals and stuff like that. We've had a lot of fun with it, but I don't want the entire zoo to, you know, be exactly the same, basically. Depending on how long that zoo goes on for, but I've already had an extra animal, so we'll see what happens. And I've started building an actual zoo kind of thing. But right now, just still working on the first set. This was pre-sloth. B-S, I guess, before sloth. And just building a very simple little holdy-up system. That's the official word we're going to use, the holdy-up system, yes. Oh, I forgot I didn't have a queue either. Just something to support the train tracks, basically. This whole area needs buildings and shops and all this kind of detail work, but that's something we'll get to in the future. Now we're on to the zoo. So, Amsterdam does indeed have a zoo called Artis. A-R-T-I-S. And My idea is to, you know, because a lot of the zoo is based on Amsterdam, is to basically take artists for inspiration. So this whole opening section is very heavily based on artists. So the, am I pronouncing that correctly? I don't know. Artists? I don't know how I should pronounce it. The whole, basically all of it is based on it. If I think there's something that can be changed to better suit what I'm doing, I will happily edit it. You know, I'm not doing a recreation here. That's not the idea. That is the idea, but only to an extent. And then if I get bored, I don't do it, basically. I'm not trying to do like a one-to-one kind of thing. Some people do that, some immensely talented people do that, but it's not really my kind of thing. It's a whole different sort of creativity to do that. You don't get to come up with your own ideas and your own madness, which I quite like doing, but creatively using the options available to you in Planet Zoo to build something in a one-to-one manner is actually very, very difficult. There's someone, I cannot remember their name, but I did retweet it. If you want to check out my Twitter, it's linked down below. I can't remember their name, but they've done like a recreation of Copenhagen, and it is possibly the best building work I've ever seen in Planet Zoo. It is phenomenal stuff. It doesn't get better, as far as I'm, it is literally the best I've ever seen, so I really recommend you check that out. Artists, the ticket booth, as you walk in, it's got this like multi-toned wooden building, but it tilts forward at the front, at the top bit, this bit where I am now, tilts towards, you know, the rest of the park, basically. So I was messing around with different things. I couldn't really make it work, so I figured, you know what, I'll just use actual individual planks of wood and I'll build the tilt in myself, essentially. It also leans, it bulges out a little in the middle, and it also leans slightly forward. It's actually a really annoying shape. But, I'm trying to relatively match it at this point in time, and started to build a little ticket booth sort of thing. There was a lot of building work in this video. There's a lot of building work in this entire park. It's something that I have gone from hating to surviving. Enjoying at times, but again, only really enjoying when I'm inspired. I have to have like a very clear idea in mind of what it is I want to achieve, and if I've got that, I feel quite good. If I don't have that, I start to struggle. Ow. It's actually really painful. Ow! I can't bite down. Oh my god. Anyway, so just is that ASMR? Does that count? Wait, shall I bring the mic? I'm gonna bring the mic closer. You ready? I've got no idea what that's gonna sound like. Incredibly sexy is the only bet I've got. I need everyone to calm down because I'm sure you're all gonna be very excited about what you just heard. How? Just building the little thing into the wall. It's hard to. This zoo isn't seemingly the most popular zoo. There's a lack of content out there. I found one amazing video online where someone did like an hour and a half long video, like a full on 4K tour sort of thing. That was immensely helpful for this build. Everyone else's video is very short, very vloggy. You know what I mean? It's less a intellectual exercise. I guess it's more hype merchant kind of stuff. Not that I'm judging, don't get me wrong. But that video was very, very useful. So this is not what the entrance looks like, but this is something I took from somewhere else in the zoo. I'm going to, like I say, pick and choose. It's not meant to be one-to-one, but the vibe is meant to be artist-esque is the idea, I suppose. Anywho, there's a little gold eagle. It's more like a yellowish eagle, really, but it's like a golden eagle on the entrance sign. We don't have enough things. This is those, I don't think they're even there, but this is, you know, when you get a ticket and then you go through, you see them at football stadiums a lot, and you push through the metal boundary and it spins around. Building one of those. It's the kind of thing that I just never would have bothered with in the past, but it just adds a little something, you know. It's nice. It's a nice little thing to add in. It's the kind of thing I'd like to do a little bit more of. Just to care, really. Ow. So much hate. Oh, why do I have to talk for a living? Why can't I be like a nun or something? Well, okay, there's a few reasons why I can't be a nun, to be fair. Why can't I be a... Who doesn't talk in their job? Mimes. Yes, I'm going to be a mime. That was really the most obvious answer out of all of them. It's literally in the job description. Anyways, yeah, little ticket, but this area needs a little bit more work. I need a A little something on the right hand side, like a little building or something. I think there's another building in the same style with these like multi-toned wooden planks. I don't actually know what it is. Couldn't see that, but it is there. And now we get to build on terrain again for the first time in literally the entire zoo. You get to actually have a path on the terrain. This was a massive, massive pain in the ass, by the way, because I wanted the path to be super thick and also straight. And to get those two things to happen, as you can see, there's a lot of finagling around with the path. I'm pretty sure I end up deleting all of this at some point. Or maybe I didn't. We'll see. Oh yeah, there it goes. It took a lot of work to get this to be straight. And it isn't quite, really. If I've got one problem, problem with Planet Zoom, probably the thing I need to sort out more than anything is I lose my grid and my angles really quickly. Like, often I'll have an item and I'll shift it over to the right hand side, you know, using the arrow thingamajiggy, and it won't be straight against the item that the other one was against. It'll be a little bit further back or a little bit further forward, and it happens to me constantly. Like, all the time. It's something I need to sort out, because it does slow me down to an extent. Like, this was like a 7-hour build you're looking at here, something like that, which for me is quite a long time. Anyways, a little bit of a plaza here, lots of, you know, it's very nice, it's pleasant, it's very European in a way, you know, these hedgerows and stuff like that, and the tree selection is all European stuff. I did go into foliage and I hearted, as you can see, a bunch of foliage, and those are the pieces of foliage that, in terms of decoration, as in outside of individual habitats or themed areas, those are the foliages that I'm going to be using throughout the entire zoo. Like, pick a theme and a colour story early on and stick to it, is the general idea. Here, I'm just making sure the area on the left doesn't look too stupid. Colouring in the benches, just like they are in the actual zoo. I had a really problem with the path as well. There's no light, non-textured path. You know, we've got the asphalt, which is like a medium grey, with a bit of brown in there maybe. But it's not bright enough for what I needed. I would love to be able to change colours on path. That would be a really cool addition to the game. Or just have like a light stone path. It can have like a stony-ish texture, but I need something that's not cracked or overtly patterned. And it actually just full on is not in the game at all. It was a bit surprising, actually. Building a little thing here. Chubby golden bear, because why not? just why not, really? We don't have much in the way of decoration in some ways in the game. And for this kind of thing, it's all animal themed for some crazy reason. So you have to be a little bit, what's the word? Creative, I guess. Anyways, yeah, just building a little area, just a little sitting area, chilling out area, and then this is going to splay off into the rest of the zoo in a little moment. So, I don't know whether we're going to keep going and make like an entire zoo. I'm not committing to that idea. I just really wanted to build a sloth habitat. That's all I'm committing to right now, a sloth habitat. I do want to go back and do the ibex and the lynx over in our alpine section, and then work on the train station that's going to lead you back around to the zoo. What we do past there is up to the gods, as in myself, for I am a god. No, but I don't know at this point in time, but there's an image I've been obsessed with for a long time, since I first started this zoo, and it just wasn't appropriate early on, and it's a tropical house in the artist zoo. And the entrance has like this multi-faceted, multi-coloured, stained glass, rounded, half-circle archway at the front. And it is absolutely beautiful. The light shines through and all the trees are there. And it's got this incredible mix of like very classical architecture with this tropical aesthetic from the trees. So that's kind of what I wanted to go for. I couldn't find good imagery of the outside of the building, but I feel like the outside of the building is actually very plain. I don't think it's anything particularly special, so I kind of just made my own building up. However, there was, in that video I mentioned earlier, there's some fantastic imagery of the inside of the building and of the roof, so I kind of went from the roof backwards. I knew what I wanted the roof and the sides and the walls and the basic shape to be, and then I can kind of just build the building around that. So yeah, spent a lot of time building this building and then covered it all up with trees in a way. You can't see the bloody thing when you're inside because the tree canopies block up all of it. But yeah, it ended up quite nice, actually. I really like this mix of this vertical wood plank, really nice, and the corrugated steel, metal, plastic, whatever, I don't know if it is. Just came together really nicely, the roof. The front of the building I'm not yet convinced on. You'll see that at the end. I think it needs a little bit of love, but I couldn't think of a great idea. But we'll see. I'll leave that to you guys. You guys can give me some advice.
Love me.
Yeah, this was all a mess. None of it's in the middle. It all has to be moved. It is basically precisely what I'm on about. Like, nothing is in the exact perfect place. I just can't stick to a grid. I don't know why. My brain doesn't work in angles. My brain works in flibby flabby shapes, I suppose. If I'm allowed to be flibby flabby, I'm fine. But if I have to be straight... Anyways. Yeah, so just working on the aside. Not trying to match it exactly or something. Just trying to get the general vibe, I suppose. And there's these little windows jutting into the side. And then this kind of corrugated texture. And these... It's just this really interesting mix of lots of textures and... Not really colours. It's all this kind of pale, yellowish, whitish. Off sort of an egg white sort of ish colour. But, sort of the mix of textures and patterns was it's pretty interesting, and it's one thing I do like for the rest of the zoo. I don't know if I'm going to follow artists for the whole thing. I don't know if we're even doing the rest of the zoo, as I say, but kind of having that classical architecture, like this architecture matches the rest of the zoo. Of course it does. You know, this kind of brick limestone combination that matches what we've been doing in all of our Dale Zoo. But taking that and then putting in some other textures, some other colours, some other materials, some more modern stuff, throwing in some more glass, throwing in the tropical vibe, you know, just trying to mix things up. This building comes in very early in the zoo. It's basically the first thing everyone will go in because it's right there at the entrance. But if we were to carry this on, I would try to keep the Amsterdam vibe, but I also like the idea of just having like full-on themed areas and being able to go a little bit crazier. The mega zoo, basically. However, I have a complaint I want to talk about. These guest habitat doors are horrible to work with. Just because they're humongous, they only come in wood. You know, there's no alternative. You have to use that specific habitat gate if you want your guests to be able to walk through. And of course we do. It's a tropical house. The guests have to be able to walk through, or the thing doesn't bloody work. But they're so ugly. There's no way around it, you know. Someone, I think Leaf actually, oddly enough, who also the sloth, released a mod just today, I think it was, that hides habitat gates. You can just hide habitat gates, it turns them into null versions if you wanted to have them in a null fence, which is a pretty cool idea. I like that a lot. Sorry, I'm stretching. The problem is, I don't believe it applies to the habitat gates. Leaf, if you're watching, if you want to add the guest habitat gate thing in to that park, that would be absolutely amazing. Please, thank you. Because then I could have it open entirely. The front would just be open and all my guests would walk through. It would make me very happy. Don't you want me to be happy? Anywho, so I think this is actually a hodgepodge of two different buildings in the tropics building. But basically, through the middle, you've got this kind of segmented walking area with trees and stuff like hanging over the top of it. And then at the sides, it drops down into a watery sort of area with these big sort of dark grey rocks. And there's loads of birds there, like tropical birds hopping around doing their thing. I don't know if I'm going to go full on for like bird mods and stuff like that. I'm really hopeful we're going to get an aviary DLC for Planet Zoo this year. I think we probably will. I think it's on the cards at least. But there's a really cool birds prop pack, which I don't know who made that. God, it might well be Leaf again, it might be Nicholas, I don't know who made that one. But there's a really cool birds prop pack. Some of them are animated as well, like tropical birds. So I think we might just populate the area with some of those as well. And then the sloths will be walking around, climbing around. And then you'll have the birds kind of perched on the trees and perched on the rocks and stuff like that. So yeah, just laying out the path there and surrounding it with the mulch. That's going to be just laying out where I'm going to put my forest, essentially. I know what you're thinking. Best in slot, you should have done the detail work on the building and everything else before you covered it with trees and made it impossible to work with. You're correct, random YouTube commenter. You're very correct. It was a mistake. It was absolutely a mistake. Womp and a womp. But what are you going to do? So yeah, just started filling it with tropical foliage, really. All South America. I think it's Central / South America technically, because obviously this is for the sloth primarily. We'll chuck in some other... Oh, I'm going to chuck in the birds. I think I'm going to chuck in the birds. The only thing I'm hesitant about is obviously the game updates. And when the game updates, things break. And mods have to be updated to work in the newest version. Now with the sloth, that isn't necessarily a problem, because all I'll do is I'll get rid of the sloths before I update the game to a newer version. And then whenever the mod updates, I can bring them back in. It's not really a big deal. But if I start to populate the entire zoo with loads of different props and stuff like that, that might be more difficult to do, to track them all down and delete them. I could put them all, make sure they're all in a single group. That would make them quite easy to delete, but then it's just another thing I have to keep track of. And that's really the main reason I held off adding the birds quite yet. Yeah, so I didn't really have any ideas for this building. It needs something. I've got this big glass area. Obviously, we're going to do some decoration work and make it look nicer than this. But it needs something on the front. What I'm considering is on that big glass area, because I think, you know, it's a tropical house, you should have lots of glass. You want to get lots of light in there. You want to feel kind of like a greenhouse. You want it to feel open while still having a few of the design influences from the rest of the zoo. That's what I'm trying to implement here. I think if I maybe build a shape out of limestone or like thin rock or something like that, and build like a tropical vibe shape, like a leaf or like an animal or like an insect or something like that, or a bird, or not a sloth face because it'll look terrible, but you know, build like a geometric animal shape against the window. I think that could look really good, and I think that would elevate the building in a way that it really needs at the moment, because that's really my main problem with it. It's just a little bit blair on the front. I mean, it's fine, but I'm not going to take it home to meet my mum. Mum, I'm not bringing it home, just so you know. Anywho, staff members. Now, this is a temporary solution, because this building is not necessarily completed. I would like to extend it further outside the back, have you walk through, say, three big rooms. The first one with the sloths and the birds, maybe a babarusa in a little bit, maybe, you know, a big cat of some form, maybe the jaguar or whatever. You know, just have multiple rooms that are all tropical themed. And no crocodiles or anything, because I want to build an aquarium as well, remember. So the back of the building is temporary and will be changed later on. I did close the zoo as well because I hate the guests. And they flooded this zoo. They absolutely flooded it in no time whatsoever. It made it really difficult to see what was going on. And it just looked obnoxious. Anyways, let's hop into game. I'll come along with you this time because there's many things to talk about and to showcase. I say there's a lot going on here. So the video had to be super speedy. It's like 2,000% speed increase. Anyways, let's go. Right, welcome back. Let's check out, first of all, I'll show you what I was doing over here. So obviously this area is going to be blank for a very long time. If we do end up building the aquarium, this is where it's going to sit. That'll be the front of the building, and then the rest of the building can kind of go this way. And you'll never see outside of it, and it doesn't really matter. But the point is that this area here obviously has to be kept relatively clear. This obviously is all very much in development. I decided to close this off, as I think I mentioned, because I just think it's better. And I did a little work on the inside, but not much. I just kind of modernized it a little bit. I'm going to put some ATMs and stuff in there. I'm not too bothered about it. I don't really like interiors. I'm still getting used to building exteriors. One day we'll get to the interiors, but it's not for me quite yet. But either way, so I'm not too worried about how this area looks, because it won't look like this in the future if we go down that route. Right, so the idea is that you hop on the train and you come down here. Now this, I think, needs work, because at the moment you kind of exit the city and you go into this alpine thing and it just looks a little sudden, I would suggest. I think what we need is maybe a, not another version of this, but a much smaller, like an archway here, made out of brick and out of limestone, and it'll say, you know, leaving the city or thanks for visiting the city or something like that. And that'll be like right here, and then you'll drop down into the tree line and you'll exit on this tour, or we paint it as a tour. I think this will look a lot better when there's more stuff here and when this is built up, because at the moment it's very obvious expanse, but I think that will help quite a bit, especially. Anyways, so you're gonna head down here, and I kind of wanted it to feel like a magical mystery tour, I'm not gonna lie. So you head through the trees, very dense with foliage, but just kind of enjoying the, you know, enjoying the forest, generally speaking. Through we go. Get to this bit, which very purposely has been, you know, blocked off and made hard to see through, and then and hey, look at that, doesn't that look good? I'm quite proud of it. I'm genuinely a little bit proud of this area here. It's definitely got that vibe I was looking for, and the train track's gonna sort of, I'm gonna bring the this whole area, this obviously isn't done yet, but bring that in a little bit. And you'll get off the station here, and then I'm going to integrate the Ibex and the Lynx into this area, and then close it off. That's really all it's going to be. Brighten up Blake a little bit, maybe a little waterfall in that gap there, but this is all for future videos. And then you head around here, you head through the trees again, into the mountain. We'll do that up with some stone, and then you're going to go through here. I think we'll put some lights in here, and just make it look like you're going through a stone tunnel through the mountain. And then eventually you'll pop out all the way on the other side. You'll pop out
over here. So it's quite a long journey, but, you know, that's not unusual. And then you head down here, and then eventually, so this area on the right is going to be earmarked for the train station that's part of the zoo. So there'll be two entrances. Speaking of the zoo then, let's have a look. The entrance is quite subtle. I wanted it to, much like artists does in real life, I wanted it to very much feel like part of the city and to blend in with the city. It's not meant to stick out particularly. I do want to put some stuff here, maybe some buildings across there or some food trucks or something might fit there quite appropriately. Anyway, as you head inside, like I said, there needs to be something there. Put some trees in and stuff. There's my little artist's section. You can queue up here. That lamppost is very much in the way. Let me shuffle that out of the way. There we go. So you queue up here, go around, grab your ticket. I know it looks like they're selling ice cream and hot dogs, and the ticket is inside the hot dog, okay? You have to eat through the hot dog to get to the ticket. It's for health purposes. But you can see it's got like a slight forward tilt on it and a slight bulge upwards. Well, actually, it doesn't have the bulge, but it has a slight forward tilt that it should have. Anywho, so you go through there, you go through this. This is actually all based on the actual zoom. You go through this bit, and that is the entrance. This is very much not the kind of thing I would usually do, but it's been nice. You know, look at this grass that you haven't touched. It's just grass. Flat, mowed, mowed? Mown? I don't know. grass. So, yeah, that's strange to me. I do want to put more foliage in here, because that's my natural inclination. Oddly enough, this is obviously behind here, is the road from earlier, and then this big old gaggle of trees. Now you'll never see that, and it doesn't really look like it's part of the road, so it can kind of back onto it without looking too awkward. I think it's fine as is. I actually really like how this looks. I think the building sticking out there really helps as well, and obviously there'll be more stuff on the left and right if we carried on with this in the future. Little statue thing in the middle, some pangolins worshipping the golden the golden bear god. Again, nothing fancy or special, really. Might put some more flowers in here and some more benches and stuff and decorate it a little bit more. But let's go focus on the building. So there's my map, which is very much not the map of Artist Zoo, because I couldn't get one that looked great, and it was just looking weird. But this shows you the colour scheme I'm going for, because, again, I really like the idea of contrasting between the very classical architecture and something else. And in this case, the something else is like a Miami Vice kind of colour scheme of these dark blues, purples, and this bright sort of pink over the top of it. I just wanted to mix it up, if I'm honest. So the forest house, as you can see, with our adorable sloth picture. I believe the actual building is called the forest house, although I'm not sure. I might go into this pink here. I'm not totally convinced on that. You can see a little bit of that there as well. I found this beautiful Amsterdam city pattern, which I'm kind of overlaying on everything very slightly. So that would go there, and that's on both sides, of course, like so. So, anyways. Forest house. This is the area I probably need the most help with from you folks. You can see I've done some work. I've brought this out in like a little archway, which I think really helps make the front more interesting. That blends in nicely. Also, let me build in the stained glass that I was talking about. It is a salamander, which isn't totally relevant, but we can always bring in a salamander. Wouldn't be a big deal. And it hides this door a little bit, which is also very much what I wanted. And also let me put in a little warning about feeding the animals. I've added in some tropical beds as well of the plant life, but I didn't want to... Usually what I would do here, like if you think back to Panagar, the first tropical house I made back in the beta for Planet Zoo, I covered the area in tropical foliage, and I just thought that isn't going to work here. Now, if we were doing like a whole themed section, which is something I like the idea of in the future, that is something we could do. But for here, where we're still very close to the start and it's all very sort of prim European gardening, it didn't work to have tropical plants everywhere, at least not if they weren't inside of a planter. This is what needs developing. So my current thought is maybe if I get rid of these bits here, these sticky out bits, just on the glass, I could build a shape or some description on there. That's the one idea so far. Maybe a bug, maybe an arthropod or some description, maybe a leaf, maybe a tree, I don't know what it would be. Something on there. And then it's these side areas. I don't know what to do. I want to put a fence in, but I couldn't find a fence that really worked. Do I pick one fence style for the entire zoo? Do I theme fences? I think probably not. It was all a little bit tricky, but let's get inside anyway. Ba-da! So, pretty simple, I guess. This is very much what it looks like in reality to an extent. I've obviously adapted it a little bit, but it's kind of you walk along and it feels like the forest is kind of encroaching on the pathways, but in these very sharp staccato kind of movements, all right angles basically along the entire thing. There's my little sign, the three-toed sloth. I did Google modern animal zoo signs. I had no inspiration. And I found this lovely one that someone had done for a Komodo dragon for a real-world zoo. It wasn't like a Planet Zoo thing. And I kind of took that inspiration. And that's actually where the whole colour scheme came from. So you see that the Amsterdam city pattern, plant, because it's from, it likes plants, and a little location thing there, and then the name, and also some text, info text, there, and three-toed sloth. If we do bring the birds in, because at the moment they all say three-toed sloth, then I'll replace this with, you know, macaws and stuff like that. Put in a pathway. I just like the idea of, you know, the sloths walking past on the bridge as you walk along, and it kind of tilts and turns and goes each way and then ends up over there, kind of behind the seats. There's a look at the roof that I mentioned I'd done quite a lot of work on. Just various textures, and then it links in down here, and then under here we've got a chain link section up onto the glass roof just to stop the birds flying up and bumping their heads. Yeah, it was quite nice actually, the more I look at it. It's really helped having all this light coming. It's actually really, yeah, I'm chuffed. built in this area here, like a little side bit. I need to do this kind of thing more. People do this a lot in their zoos. I've seen it, and it tends to look really good. Just kind of like concrete barriers. It's just very realistic, I suppose. Where are the sloths? There are four sloths in here. I haven't seen any of them at this point in time. Are they around here? What are you guys doing? Just inside each other. Just doing your own thing. I promise I have animals in my zoo. I'll show you the other side anyway. Yeah, it's the same idea. So we'd have birds perching along here and on the leaves and stuff like that. I'll have to move those leaves up there to see that. But the inside I'm pretty happy with. I think this room is basically done unless someone has any genius ideas. But I'd like to work on the outside. I will admit I'm more inspired to do this than the mountain right now. So we may work on this a little bit further and sort of do another room or something like that. I don't know. But we'll see. We'll get back to the Ibex and Lynx at some point. I'm just going to work on what I'm feeling passionate about, because I think that's the best way that I keep on working on this, basically. Where are my animals? Oh, hello! There we go. So this is actually modelled on the koala. So it does use the koala, the food items and the enrichment items and all that kind of jazz. If we click on this lovely Francisca, lovely name, go on habitat, you can see they can climb up the trees, they can climb up here, they can get along the, you know, this bridge kind of thing, and they can climb up all around the entire thing, basically. It's pretty cool. They can even get in the log as well, which I didn't know, but I'd like to see. I might bring some more. I've only got four in here at the moment because that is the social dynamics of the sloth, but I mean, they're generally speaking probably very, look at her, very solitary animals, really, sloths. So I think I can have a few of them walking around and it's so cute. Oh, I love you so much. I do, from the bottom of my heart. I adore you, just so you know. Look, it matches so, you can even see it against the sign over there, how well it matches. It is phenomenal work by Leaf, it really is. And as much as I'm usually hesitant to bring in mods because, you know, problems in the future, the fact is there's no sloth in the game. And I love sloths. And I just, it had to be included. It had to be included. What are you doing, Francisca? Oh, she's climbing. She's climbing. She's very talented. Let's see if we can find one of the others. There are four of them, so why she's the only one I can find, I have no idea. Oh wait, they're all boxed in the tree, that's why. Right, there we go. What are you crazy kids up to? Doing? Get back in there, you numpties. So who have we got? We've got Francisca, we've got Margarita, we've got Abril, and we've got Pedro. Three females, one male, because that is again the social designation that they... Oh, I've never seen them actually up here. Let's see. Let's have a little look. Who are you? Who have we got here? This is Margarita. You can do it, Margarita. I believe in you, girl. Margarita bringing the skills. Yes! Love it. Very cool. She's adorable. She's absolutely adorable. I love you from the bottom of my heart. I really do. It's so well made. Big shout out to Leaf, honestly. It's brilliant stuff. But, yeah, no. Proper furry little sloth. Adorable little slothy face. And that's really about it, folks. I don't really have too much else to add. That is the forest house, I suppose. And like I say, I like the idea of having like another part here, another part here. So that's why I'm not worrying too much about this. This is only temporary, just so I can get the sloths in there, essentially. as we developed the rest of the building, if that's what we did, then obviously that would change a little bit. What I would maybe do in that circumstance is, if I did develop the building more, maybe have this go off into a whole tropical section, and that way I could maybe justify the theming a little bit stronger. But I would probably keep the trees into... I think you have to keep that sort of gardening aspect, because that's really what the entire park has been about, and it would seem silly to ditch that out of nowhere, I think. Hello. Where you off to? I haven't seen them eat yet. They've only got one food. They've only got one food source, which is this eucalyptus thing over here. Oh, down you pop. But yeah, I guess that's about it from me, folks. Let me know what you think, I guess. So yeah, if you have any suggestions for the outside, I don't know what to do with fencing and stuff like that. That's really the problem I'm having. And let me know what you think and what you want to see in the future and all that kind of general Planet Zoo jazz. I will link the mod down below. Definitely go give it some love. It is immensely well made, super adorable. And I will see you lovely folks in the next video. Thank you so much for joining me. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video. It's super appreciated and very helpful. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.